So let's take another one. Again, same thing, find vertex, focus, equation of axis, length of lattice rectum, and the parabola this time is, let's take y plus 3 the whole square is x minus 2. So please type in first the vertex. Where do you think is the vertex? So all of you are attending this session, please type where is the vertex for this parabola. All right, so try to recall this standard case. So this belongs to the standard case. This comes from the standard case y square is equal to 4ax. Okay, so just see who's playing the role of what. Capital Y's role is played by y plus 3. Capital X role is played by x minus 2. And 4a role is being played by 1, which clearly implies a is 1 by 4. Right? A is going to be 1 by 4. Now, first question is vertex. Vertex means x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. Correct? So for vertex, you would put x as 0 and y as 0. That's indicative of the 0, 0 vertex. So you'll say similarly, x minus 2 is 0, y plus 3 is 0, which means vertex would be at 2, -3. Exactly. So Vidushi is correct. Okay. Next is focus. We know focus for such cases is at a comma 0. So I'll put capital X as a and capital Y as 0. Correct? So capital X is a means X minus 2 is 1/4 and Y plus 3 is 0, which means X is going to be 9 by 4 and Y is going to be minus 3. So let's combine it up. Let's combine it up and your focus would be at 9 by 4, -3. Correct? Next is equation of the directrix. Equation of the directrix. So we know for y square is equal to 4ax, equation of the directrix is x equal to minus a. So in our case, it will become x is x minus 2, minus a is minus 1 by 4. In other words, 4x plus minus 7 equal to 0 would become your equation of the directrix. So this becomes the equation of the directrix. Next is the equation of the axis. Equation of the axis. Equation of the axis, we know y is equal to 0. That means y plus 3 equal to 0 is your equation of the axis, plain and simple. And finally, the case of length of lattice rectum. Length of lattice rectum is 4a. Length of lattice rectum is 4a. Lattice rectum is 4a, which is going to be 4 times 1 by 4, which is 1 unit. Which is 1 unit. All right, guys. So this is the critical points and critical equations for the parabola, which I just now gave to you. Okay, let's take one more. Again, find the same things. Vertex, focus, equation of directrix, equation of axis, length of lattice rectum for this parabola. Third one. Let's take x minus 1 the whole square is, let's say, 36 times y plus 3. Okay. Again, let's quickly discuss it. So this belongs to which species? So this has come from which standard form? This has come from standard form x square is equal to 4ay, where you can realize that the role of x is being played by x minus 1. The role of y is being played by y plus 3. And the role of 4a is being played by 36. That means a is your 9. A is 9 in this case. Okay. Now, vertex. When I talk about vertex, the vertex for such kind of a parabola is 0, 0. So we'll say x is 0, capital X is 0, and capital Y is 0. Right? Which means x minus 1 is 0 and y plus 3 is equal to 0. Which means x is 1 and y is minus 3. Which means 1 comma minus 3. 1 comma minus 3. Okay. Now, next is focus. We know focus for such cases is at 0 comma a. So I will write x as 0 and y as a. Okay. And just we'll make a role change. So x minus 1 is equal to 0 and y plus 3 is equal to 9, which means x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 6. Okay, so 1 comma 6 is going to be your focus. Next is equation of the directrix. Equation of the directrix for such cases is y equal to minus a, right? So I will say small y plus 3 is equal to minus 9 or y plus 12 equal to 0 is the required directrix. Now D part, equation of the axis. We know equation of the axis for a parabola like this, x square is equal to 4ay, is your y-axis itself. That means x equal to 0. So we'd say the equation of the desired parabola axis is going to be x minus 1 equal to 0. And finally, length of lattice rectum. Length of lattice rectum is 4a. And 4a here is going to be 36 units. 4a is going to be 36 units. Now, many a times the equation that would be given to you will not be in a very straightforward manner as what I had given to you, right? For example, they may give you a question like this. Find vertex focus equation of directrix. Equation of axis, length of lattice rectum, for this parabola x square plus 8x plus 12y plus 4 equal to 0. Try this out and please feel free to post your response of vertex first on the chat box. So guys, in this case, we have to first bring it to a generalized form. In the present scenario, it is expanded. Okay. So we have to see first, is it a quadratic in X or a quadratic in Y? It's obvious that it's a quadratic in X, correct? So it would be either of the form x square is equal to 4ay or it would be of the form x square is equal to minus 4ay. So which of the two forms? Let us find it out by completing the square. So first we'll complete the square over here. For completing the square, we all know that when you have an 8 over here, we half it and square it and add over here. So half of 8 is 4. Square of 4 is 16 And in a similar way, we subtract a 16 because 16 was originally not present. So this will form x plus 4 whole square. This will form x plus 4 the whole square. And rest of the terms, I'll take it to the other side. That means I'm going to take minus 12y plus 12 on the other side. Okay. So minus 12y plus 12, I'll take it on the other side. Now, remember, I have to convert it to a generalized form. Generalized form is where your expression should either look like y minus k square is equal to 4a x minus h, or it should look like this, or it should look like this. Or it should look like this. So these are the four generalized forms. Okay. Remember, in all these forms, your coefficient, the direct coefficient of x and y, is actually 1. That's why I took a minus 12 common over here. I took a minus 12 common over here. So these are your generalized forms. These are your generalized forms. Okay. Now, try to compare it with the standard case. So x square, this will be behaving as your x, capital X. This is going to behave as your minus 4a, and this is going to behave as your capital Y. Okay. So now there is a role change. The role change is your capital X role is being played by small x plus 4. Capital Y role is being played by small y minus 1. And minus 4a role is being played by minus of 12. That means a is going to be 3. Okay. Correct. So vertex we know is 0, 0. That is x is 0, y is 0. So you'll say x plus 4 is 0, y minus 1 equal to 0. So correct, Shreya. Your answer is correct. So your vertex would be at, your vertex would be at minus 4, comma 1. Absolutely correct. Next, focus. We know for such cases, focus is at 0, comma minus a. 0, comma minus a. So I'll write x plus 4 as 0 and y minus 1 as minus a, right? Minus a would be minus of 3, right? So it will become minus 4 and y would become minus 2. So minus 4 comma minus 2 would be your focus. Is that fine? Next is equation of the directrix. Equation of the directrix. So equation of the directrix for such cases is known to be y equal to a. So I will say y minus 1 is equal to 3. So y minus 4 equal to 0 would be your equation of the directrix. Next is equation of the axis. Equation of the axis in this case is x equal to 0. So it simply becomes x plus 4 equal to 0 as the equation of the axis. Length of the latter sectum is 4a, which is actually 12 units. Actually 12 units. So I hope you guys have understood the case of generalized form of the equation of a parabola, and we have done a lot of problems based on that. So we'll take up a question directly. Find the equation of the parabola with lattice rectum. With lattice rectum joining joining 3, 6 and 3, -2. 3, 6 and 3, -2. So please remember here, you have been given just this information that the lattice rectum of that particular parabola is joining these two points, 3, 6. Okay. 3, 6 and 3, -2. So let's say this pink lattice rectum. So remember, we could have two cases of a parabola. One is like this. So one, as you can see in white. And one could be in red. It could be like this. To find both the equations of the parabola, one in red and one in white. So let me give you some time. You may try it out. Very simple case. So clearly it's a case of a general form of a parabola, because your axis will still be parallel to the x-axis. This will be parallel to the x-axis. So first focus on the white one. All right, so if I just ask you about the white one, okay. First of all, the distance between these two. What is the distance between these two? That is 4a. 4a is going to be 8, isn't it? So a is going to be 2, correct? Now the midpoint of this is going to be 3, 2, right? So if I ask you, what is going to be the vertex? So you're going to say for vertex, you just have to move 2 units along the x-axis. So this point is going to be 1, 2. Remember, this distance will always be a. Okay. Now, having found the vertex and having known a, we can easily write down the equation of the white parabola, which is going to be y-2² is 8 x-1, right? So if you know the vertex and if you know the parabola is opening rightwards, it is supposed to have the equation of the form y² = 4ax, and y is now being played by y-2 and x is now being played by x-1. Okay. Similarly, for the red parabola, the vertex would be at 5, 2. The vertex will be at 5, 2. Right? So for such case, the equation of the parabola will become y-2² is -8 x-5. Right? So this solves the problem. So it's a case of a shifted parabola or a generalized parabola.